Prince, UFC Oak Lawn Gym, heading from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 169 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, Prince Pogasar! Pogasar! His opponent this evening hails from Marengo, Illinois, and represents UFC Jim Lombard, weighing an even 170 pounds, Gerald the Twitch Cristione! Cristione!
All right, here we go.
Yeah, this is our final gladiator challenge, and I think there's a reason they made this one the final, sort of the grand finale, is because I think these two are going to be putting on a show, even though they've only been training 10 weeks, they're very athletic looking.
Yeah, they look in great shape. And hands are high at least. That's a good start. Oh, nice overhand by Trace.
Yeah, Trace is 19.
Oh, he just ate a right hook.
And he's going to school at Loyola to be a doctor. So just decided to get in there and see what he got.
Yeah, got to do it now if you're going to be a doctor. You're going to spend the rest of your life in school. Oh, takedown, but then reversed and mounted. This
great
is a bad
reversal.
Position. Yeah.
By Gerald.
Yeah, kind of hipped in and caused the reversal. Now he's giving up his back. No, he has the arm in, so he's K. Nice. Look at that double. I'm impressed.
Yeah, they're...
Now...
Trace said he was a grappler. He definitely likes to grapple. That I guess he did a little bit in high school.
Gerald's doing the right thing here. He's got his hip down. He's trying to get guard. I mean, I think he could have gone to that hip and tried to stand up. He's managed to get a half guard. He's got control of the head, but there's really nothing here for him. Nice hip.
He wants to be careful not to wear out that arm too
early. Yeah. And good job, Trace, just keeping his hips down and just pushing him over. And why did he give him? Oh, he gave him mount to do that. No one sort of. Oh, what's happening here? Oh, he's like Von Flute choking him a little bit, kind of.
He's got to be careful to wear out that arm. He committed to that for over 2 minutes.
Now Gerald gets a double, but he's caught in a guillotine. Doesn't have control of the body, though. It's not particularly dangerous. He should keep wrist control, though, just in case Trace gets that. He's sliding that knee under to try to get full guard. He's doing the right thing. Should control the other wrist. Oh, nice, just nice uppercut there. He's gotta make sure to keep that whizzer. He's gonna go nice knee. Oh, to the junk again.
Looked like it might have been right on the border.
Yeah, maybe took more of a foot than the knee, but I don't know, I couldn't see it from here.
Nonetheless, those do hurt.
They do hurt. Trace taking a moment here. This doesn't really benefit either person since it was just an all-out grappling match with no one really getting much of an advantage, so... Oh, he just ate another right hook. Two of them. Now they're just winging hooks left and right. Not a lot of...
overhand
nice right.
Overhand right.
Yeah.
They're just going to town here. This is a fun fight to watch, at least.
Well, you were sure right. They seem to have the most skill, and they're the most athletic, and they're going at it.
Yeah, Gerald just... training for about 2.5 months.
Oh, just ate a big double there. He took a deep breath. It's wide open, yeah. Now, every time Trace has mounted, Gerald has let him mount and then rolled him. And it's worked for him a couple times. Not sure who to give that to.
I think I'd probably give it to Trace. He did have a little more top control, though. He did get reversed a couple times. He had some big punches there towards the end.
Yeah.
Gerald backing up a little bit and getting pursuit. Big overhand right. It was probably the biggest shot of the fight so far.
Yeah, and he's initiating a lot of the takedowns, even though Gerald did quite well himself. So close one. Maybe you're right. Maybe Trace's round.
Yeah, definitely a close round. They're very evenly matched. And, we give that up to the UFC gym and to Fight Card, who put this one together.
Yeah, this one's been fun. All right, so let's see what they got for the second round. Are they just going to scrap again, or is someone going to be a little more methodical here and try to take control of this fight?
Yeah, I wonder if anybody at the gyms, because they do train at different gyms, Gerald being from Lombard and Trace being from Chicago Ridge, I wonder if they're going to implement any sort of game plan.
Yeah, thus far it does not seem so. We'll see if there are any adjustments were made in between. And now they're winging punches again.
Yeah, I think kind of when you have such limited training, you just kind of go back on what you know.
Yeah.
And it looks like that's just overhand rights.
Now these are these are tough guys, clearly, and you know, right now the punches are getting all loopy. Those were straight. Yeah, if Gerald had actually turned that into an uppercut, that would have gone right to the chin, right underneath the elbow, instead of a hook. A right hook is very hard to land unless you're in real close. You see how Gerald is not extending on his punches? There, that was much better. He drifted. Oh, he caught him with the right hook. Just when I say the right hook is hard to land. And rightfully, Trace goes for the double. That's smart.
He's got his hands.
Yeah, he's got him passed.
He did get it.
I'm not sure why Gerald was bothering to punch there. He really should have been working to get his base so that this didn't happen.
And actually, it looked like Trace might have slammed him down and hit his own head on the mat there.
Oh, that does happen sometimes. And mount again. Now Trace has got to sit down so that he doesn't get rolled, and Gerald could actually use the cage. And here it is again. He lets him get mount, and then he kind of just shifts his hips and gets him over.
Yeah, as if Trace moves on with this training, he's probably going to want to either work on that or work on trying to get a side control. This doesn't happen.
Yeah, you know, as we saw in the last card where people were too quick to mount, and mount is dominant, but it's also easier to reverse than, say, side control is. Well, for ground and pound, half guard is fine. If you're on top and half, you just pinch on that leg and just rain down punches. But this is not good, obviously. Yeah, that's not going to do it.
It's kind of far from the cage, so you can't even use the cage to sort of get off.
Yeah, this is dangerously close to being stopped. And Trace looks tired, and that's when the mount really sucks. That's it. Well, Gerald dug deep, and a good win. He seemed to have just a little more cardio, and that's what saved the day for him. Good fight, even match.
Strikes your winner, the Twitch Gerald Christiane.